will be cutting the springs of the yellow thing today. Just because I don't have a loading kit or coilovers doesn't mean I can't go low. So you guys can still see right here, the springs are still standard. And I will be cutting this set because I still have a space set in the garage just in case, well, I get my test pulled or something like that, or I just want to lift the car up again, whatsoever. But I think I might just take 2.5 rings off in front for now and take off 2 rings at the back. Yeah, 2 rings at the back because the gap is quite big at the back as well. Just note the car is lifted up in front, that's why the gap is this big at the back. But I think 2 springs will do the trick at the back. And yeah, it'll be a quick, very quick video. Just gonna use the grinder as is. Just note, this is very, very dangerous. And make sure whenever you're grinding off the springs that there's enough clearance wherever you'll be grinding, because here's like the beginning point of the spring, here's 1 spring, that's 2. So I'll be cutting 2.5, which will be here. And I think there will be enough clearance for me to actually like cut the springs. And just know there will be like a massive force that's going to be applied whenever the spring is like going to break off. So just be careful whenever you're busy with that. Jody and TJ is that side playing around with the Civic. The Civic is once again going into where, Jody? Well, we don't know the place's name, but there's somewhere like there, the back of Coles River. And we'll be dropping off the Civic tomorrow. You guys can join us on a video or on a ride along to drop off the Civic. Huh? Oh, nah, Jody doesn't want us to come with. It's fine. Anyways, let's start off cutting the springs. I'm gonna start off in front, this side, then I'm gonna go to the back, this side, and then I'll just be moving on to that side. I'm not really sure if I should cut off half, yeah, more on the one side than the other side, but I'll be cutting it equally for now, and I'll see the height differences on both sides. So, enjoy the video. That was super quick for the one side. I mean, like, it took me less than a minute just to get the spring out and cut off with the grinder, which is right here. Just make sure you guys always have protection, eye protection for the spark, and well, just have maybe like a body armor on as well, because the spring shoots the wrong direction. Okay, it can't actually shoot the wrong direction, but if something does go wrong, you are fully equipped with a body armor, whatever. But just be safe whenever you're cutting springs this way. The right way is actually to remove the entire strut, remove the spring, cut it off, and reassemble everything. But I'm just super lazy and I like to do it backyard style, and this is how we do it. So let's move on to the back. Note, whenever you're gonna be lowering the car with cut springs in, we'll have to get the spring in the right position like this. So just be careful for your entire arm and hand whenever lowering the car. But it's always best to actually have 2 people doing this. One person should be holding the spring and the other person should be loading the car with the jack. But yeah, we'll just hear maybe like a loud bang when the spring will be shooting in place. But yeah, that's like that's just like part of the entire cut spring process. Well, this is the height in front. This far it's like 2 fingers, which is quite decent. So I'm gonna move on to the rear, and once that car, that side is lowered, and that side is lowered, with the entire car lowered, then we'll be able to see the exact height of the car. But for now, it still seems right. I think it's gonna lower slightly, little bit if that side in front is lowered. But for now, it's quite decent. And just keep in mind, that's 2.5 springs, so I feel it is quite decent. And the car might still, yeah, it might still handle alright. Not like the Civic. Yes, bro. This car shouldn't take the Civic's duck tonight. Uncle Lani. Anyways, let's move to the back. Unfortunately, with the back strut, you'll have to remove the entire strut. So to remove the entire strut, there's a nut in the bolt at the bottom, which is 17s. Here on top, it's also a 17, right here. You remove that one, then you remove this entire unit, and there's another 17 keeping the top bucket, or keeping the spring in place, and you'll have to remove that. Obviously, you'll have to clamp the spring, which I'm not going to do as well, I'm too lazy. And then you cut these springs on top. Just note you don't cut them at the bottom, you cut them on top, so you'll be cutting off one, two. Here's the one, there's one, two, we're cutting off there, and then the car will be a little bit lower. So let's get started. Note at the back that the spring will also be loose, just a little, because I took off like too much. I actually just took off two springs, but whenever you're lowering the car, same applies for the rear as in the front. Whenever you're lowering the car, get someone to keep the spring in place. It needs to be in place, well, right about here, I think. So just make sure it is in place, and then if it is in place, then you're sorted. So yeah, good job. This far it looks like I got the measurements correct, because the front is like a slight bit, little bit lower than the rear. But for now I'm just going to turn the car around and I'm going to do the exact same things and steps. I follow this side on that side to get that side lower as well. So I'm just going to put you guys in a time lapse for that entire process that side while I'm turning around the car. What? Is it okay that I put you guys in a time lapse? Just comment down below.
Okay.
I just finished loading the other thing. I got all four springs ready cut, and unfortunately I had to cut off another half on the driver's side in front. So just note, the driver's side in front has three rings off, the pistons side in front has 2.5 rings off, and both rear ends has 2 rings off. So whenever you want to lower your car, specifically talking about carburetor, just like the weight of the motor like plays like a big role, because on the one side it has like more heavy on the one side than the other side, and that's the reason why I had to cut off another half on the driver's side. And the car is actually very level, as you guys can see in the cinematics, and I'm really like happy with the drive as well. Like, it hops like a little bit, but it doesn't like hop you out of place or anything like that. It feels almost like same drive as coilovers, just on a very like lower value and on a higher height. But I'm completely happy, and I hope you guys are happy, because many of you guys wanted me to lower the car once again. I'm not sure it's like kind of like loading kit you guys would like to see in the car, but cut springs is not too bad at all, and I still need to take the car for roadworthy, so I might just fit the highest springs once again whenever I'm going to take the car for roadworthy, and I still need to collect the papers for the car. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please do like and please do subscribe to the channel. More content is definitely coming up soon, and Shannon just want to say something to you guys. Okay, Shannon,
and ghost hunt.